I'll leave you alone for once, I promise. If you answer this one question for me, hold up.
I just sing it. Are they going to flag if we sing it though?
They might.
Okay, so
it depends on how good we sound. If we sound like, good,
bitch.
No, flag on the play.
Right.
That was the smooth sounds of Neo. Do you still think of me anymore? Download the song if you don't have it already. You can get it on your DSP near you. Digital streaming platform.
I was about to say, what is that?
I know. I saw the way you look like.
I was like, yeah, right, cool. That'll work. I was like, desktop?
Let me tell you. Desktop. I don't know what the piece that. Desktop player. Talk about it.
Right.
Listen, I thought about this song, Do You? And it's another song I really like. If you are in a situation, I sound like a law office, if you or somebody you know have been injured in a car accident and have got metropisilioma, what is it called?
Mesothelioma. I probably still said that.
Mesothelioma.
You may qualify for it.
You may qualify. But Do You is one of those songs that if you have that queued up on your I Need My Girl Back playlist, you might get her back. This Dirty Mackin, though. I just wonder, do you think of me? Jagged Edge, He Can't Love You. It's a bunch of them like that. But boy, like this one's top tier.
They don't make music like that no more. Niggas ain't banging on songs no more.
They ain't. My nigga said, first off, congratulations on your daughter. And if she looks anything like her mother, she must be the prettiest thing in the world. Hold
on. I mean, I can relate to that line.
It's fire this weekend. We seen them. We talking about it.
Oh my God.
Hey, they
were
out there.
Nasty work.
Hey, man, he played about.
Oh my God.
Dude. Book 10.
Yeah, okay.
You crazy. That's a book 10.
Oh, so let me tell you. Then we're going to put a pin in that. I didn't know it was that Do You. I thought it was the Miguel Do You.
Ooh.
Feel like now that's my shit.
Yep.
Me too.
I like that too.
Me too.
I used to do it at the Indie when she used to get mad. But I did the edited radio edited version. So Indie would be like mad. Hugs.
Do you like hugs?
That's so creepy.
And she like, get away from me. Then she felt that pelvis rub up against that thigh. She could not deny my love. Sometimes you gotta put your meat on your wife's leg to let her know you're still there.
Meat to meat.
Meat to meat to meat. And double entendre. Don't even ask me how.
Shout out to the kids.
Hey, yo. Let me tell you something, ladies. Ooh, all this ties in great. We're going to do a homecoming recap, first of all. We got to talk about what happened this past weekend. Big Syd came. Oh, we got to introduce ourselves. This is GNR Podcast. I am your host, B Love. And like always, I have my very pregnant host with me.
Syd the Kid.
Syd the Kid with the kid in the building.
Me and the kid was outside this weekend.
Listen, Billy shining like a crystal ball. You outside, not Friday, but Saturday too.
And Sunday.
You went out and Sunday.
We were together all weekend.
I like that. I, you know what? And I must be getting old because I be liking stuff like that. I like to go out and with family. It's weird. It gets weird. I'm getting older.
But those are the people you have the most fun with. I feel like we have a great time.
We do have a good time. Even just being around each other.
Yeah.
I'm like, damn, this is cool. Like I like
this guy.
I like it. This is normal. This is a normal. I like this.
And then our kids love each other. Yep. Now that we got kids, it even makes even more sense.
But talk about your husband, what he did. Let's just skip to that point.
My God. He's going to be so...
Damn, dude. He got
an attitude with me for that, too, for
bringing it up.
Yes. I text Indian.
Oh, he shouldn't have got an attitude. My bad.
Anyway, and I do have a question for you offline. But anyway, Okay. Tell me overall, since it was your homecoming, Cameron, my husband, went to MTSU. It was Big MTSU Cam. Homecoming. These guys are Blue Raiders. I'm a Bruin.
You're a Bruin. That's right.
I'm a Belmont Bruin. But I feel like I went to MTSU because my mom went to MTSU.
Everybody.
I lived on MTSU campus. I went to the daycare. So technically, I guess I did go to MTSU.
You went. You were there before all of us.
During, after, and all the time. So, yeah. So, how was your homecoming experience?
To me, now this is to me, and I might have recency bias. This was the best homecoming, aside from the homecoming probably about right before COVID, 2019. I was about
to say, before COVID, everything was the best.
Fountains. The night we had that party at the Fountains. The Fountains, if you don't know, is an event space in Murfreesboro that only let us use a party there, only let us have a party there one time because, boy, it was fun.
Y'all showed y'all black asses, huh?
Showed their black asses. The women did. And I talked about this before. They ripped the bathroom door off of the hinge and we lost our security deposit and that was the last time that the Fountain seen us.
Yeah, okay.
Grand opening, grand closing. But this time, it was good. Party Friday night was a vibe. It was on the rooftop. It's called Legacy. Shout out to G2, Tony, Derek, all the homies. It was on the rooftop. Very demure.
Very cutesy.
Cutesy, as they one would say. Everybody came dressed in their finest threads. It looked like a real groovy time.
It was grown and sexy.
The weather was perfect, but it was a little on the hotter side.
So it wasn't perfect. Had it been like a smooth 69 out there, it'd have been smooth.
Freak ass nigga, you said.
It's a balance. 70. That's right.
Okay. 70. But no, it was humid. Hot. It was humid. It was humid. Yeah. So had homecoming been in October, mm-hmm. I feel like it normally is. I had a long sleeve shirt on at tailgate, so let's go there now. I'm at tailgate.
Wait. No. Let's put a pin. Let's put a bow on the party.
Let's go back
and
get my phone out.
I came to the party. I had 45 minutes left in there.
You
bitch,
did.
Because the party ended at 12. I was like Cinderella. I had a few minutes. Ran up in there. You know, my cheetah girl. Cheetah.
You look good, though.
I was a moment.
Hope y'all.
Okay? I had my belly covered. I told you I was covering it.
You did. But you had a little shawl right here. A little halter top thing going on.
Yeah, it was a little, you know what I'm saying? A little tea moment. You know what I'm saying? It was a time. India looked good. I looked good. The girls looked good.
Yep.
We looked good.
I ain't seen nobody in there that was out of place. Nobody in there looked crazy. Like everybody came dressed to impress. And I appreciated that.
I guess.
So much so. it was a lot of old work in the building, if you know what I'm saying. It was a lot of old work.
Okay, next. We're going to go to the tailgate.
Okay. All right. So then we get to the tailgate. Got to the tailgate. Ordered a long sleeve shirt because I figured that, you know, homecoming was in October. Unbeknownst to me, well after I ordered the shirt, homecoming's in September. It was 90 damn degrees outside, probably hotter than that.
And I told you, I was like, you were going to sweat your ass off. I mean, it was a very nice shirt.
Cute, you didn't say that.
Very cutesy.
I like it.
Very kappa, very cutesy.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
And it was very hot.
It had the nerve to be a thick one.
You got to run there with Megan October.
Listen, man, my neck started to sweat. It's bad when this part of your body sweats right
your
here.
Wrist?
Like this wrist, yeah. Not this part of your body.
This part.
And shoulders. But man, the girls were outside. Big Winter was in the building one time.
Oh.
Two times. Big City in the building. No, I didn't say Sydney. I said City, my daughter. It's a nickname.
And Big Black was in the building. The biggest
was in the building. We had a good time. I feel like tailgate was real family oriented.
It was. A lot
year.
Of people had their kids
a lot
out
of people
there.
Had
and
the
I
kids.
Liked it.
I did too. I like seeing y'all grow. I like seeing you grow out there, people.
It made me feel more adult than I ever had before.
Yeah, I did kind of like, damn, do I need to pull up a barbecue grill next year?
I mean, somebody needed to. Yeah. There wasn't enough food out there for me.
That's one thing about, the black side. You go to the
niggas
white people's side.
Niggas just out there trying to be seen, I guess.
I guess that's what it's for.
But I mean, I would have loved to have a chicken tender and hot dog.
Listen, a hot dog, I want that glizzy in the house.
Me too.
You had too many glizzes in you.
Oh my!
Because of the baby. Not like too many. It's like one person, but with the one glizzy.
I was married now. Anywho, glizzy room.
But it was hot. I stayed out there for a maximum of 30 minutes.
I think we were out there for an hour.
I didn't think y'all were here. Yeah, I probably would.
Because y'all left. I didn't even know y'all was gone.
I told y'all.
It was too hot to say goodbye.
It was. Never can say goodbye. But I had to say it that time because I was out the door. The baby's faces started getting red.
Oh, yeah. Winter was done for out there. Her little pink face.
Winter looked like.
She literally, it's like she had blush on. She was so
hot. Damn, where did you get that makeup from, babe?
Oh, it's not makeup. It was hotter than a bitch up
there. But people had their fans out. Now we'll say, I got to give it up. It was some young alphas out there. They had some nice t-shirts and it said the 14 on it. Now I give it up to y'all because we posted you all on the Black MTSU alumni page. And out of 14 of y'all, 12 of y'all was there. That's unusual activity. So give it up one time. It was a good time. And then after the tailgate, we went to the day party. Give it up.
I did. At that point, I had had enough of MTSU. I had seen all that I needed to see.
That's where you stop. Yeah. The buck stops here.
The buck stopped there, and the belly was out at the tailgate.
Yeah, had the belly out.
It was enough.
You had the pants undid.
I did.
Okay, see, I'm looking at my friend.
I was going to come
in like
something
that.
Else, and then I was like, I think I'll be my coolest in this, and I was still higher than a bitch.
Yeah, it was
high. I had on a little, you know, tube top, a little jean button, but, you know, that's my look.
It is. That's your thing. That's your thing.
But yeah, no, I was partied out.
Going back to tailgate, you know what I thought about? There wasn't no shade out there for real either, though.
It was from the trees and some of the tents, but the tents weren't even shady. And then you really couldn't even be under the tents.
And hot ass ass, because black people was under the tents, too. And everybody was trying to crowd around. Body
it was just hot.
I was uncomfortable.
It was miserable. Yeah, I was.
That's what it was.
I don't think any amount of clothing would have been comfortable out there.
Yeah, and you couldn't be cool. I mean, you sweated your cool out. By the time you got out there, the cool was gone.
Yeah, I had the gel from last night on, some Boja. My hair was still curled up on the side. I was like, yeah, it's about that time.
Hey, the cool sweat right on up. And you needed a hat out there.
You needed more than that. You needed an AC unit attached to your back.
That's a fact. And they said homecoming going to be in September for the next 5 years. I heard.
I don't know if we'll be out there next year.
Yeah, why? I'm going to be out there because it was so good that after we left. Now, tailgate was a good time.
I'm saying all that to say
tailgate was fun. I think the day party feeds off of tailgate. Mm-hmm. And what I mean by that, if the tailgate is turned up, then you can always guarantee that the day party to get lit is going to be turned up. And that's where we went. Straight from there to get lit. Turn up! I want to give a big shout out to the GOAT in Murfreesboro for having us. You guys did an immaculate job, even though I told you to have more servers on staff and more bartenders. You didn't listen to me, but you my girl. And you said that we can get it back. We can run it back next year and you will be fully staffed. I owe you some flowers too. I haven't forgot.
Maybe I'll be there next year.
Hell yeah, you will.
Actually, I'm about to be everywhere next year. Anybody homecoming, y'all want me there? Tell me the pull up. Tell me the day and time. I'm there.
And we're going to Howard, Hampton, all them.
Oh, yeah. Let's do it.
We can share. I ain't never been before, but we going to do it today, you know. And shit, I don't know how it is being a married man going to these type of homecoming events, but try it out and see.
Double date it out.
Hey, but the get lit was exactly what it said. Now, the thing I don't like about Negros. We like to congregate in one place. The GOAT was big enough. They had indoor and outdoor pool. Got 7 Rolls Royces parked outside in the front anyway. Shout out to Ray J. But it did have a whole outside area where you could have like frolicked out. The GOAT reminded me of the rooftop. How it was inside, outside, but just not on the roof.
But I feel like niggas had had enough outside time. So if they wasn't outside, they had just come from outside.
Yeah, you're right.
And it's probably best that they was inside before you had motherfuckers falling out. And then the GOAT be like, you got people in here drunk
in the GOAT, smelling like a GOAT.
Yeah.
Shit, get them out of here.
Yeah.
But hey, lovely event. Great people, great to work with. Can't wait to come back next year. So if you haven't got your tickets for next year, they're available right now.
No, they're not.
But it was a good damn time. So, hey, man, thank everybody for rocking with us. We appreciate it. And I know a lot of y'all went to the climax. I'm glad y'all rock with that, too. But, we'll be back next year, you know. Coming back. Run it back. Run it back.
I think you're like a homecoming guy, though.
Who? Me?
You.
I am a homecoming guy.
I feel like, because you host parties and stuff like that. How many years have you been throwing homecoming parties?
I've been doing it for a long time, man. shout out to Drake.
Like 10 years?
Mm-mm, longer than that. Chill. Chill, longer than that. I'm in India 14 years. 14 years.
So, yes, you are the homecoming guy. You're the mayor of homecoming.
I know. Homecoming mayor. Give it up. Now, the day party is where I shine. I like the Friday night party, but the day party is where I thrive. I love it. I like day parties. I'm more of a day party guy. I tried to go out that night, but when you turn 34. All right, let's put it out there. When you turn 34 or above, 33 and a half almost, if you go to a day party and then somebody say, well, after this, we going to another location and you don't take a nap in between, kudos to you because you are now a party animal. I can't do it. Let me tell you. So I said, bet. I don't even drink, but I was like, we're going to leave the day party and we're going to pull up to the night party. I went home. I got dressed. I left the house. I got dressed and left the house. It's 10:30 at this point.
Did you take a nap?
No.
Okay.
Pull up to the first spot. Wasn't that many people in there. Pull up to the second spot. Climax. Too many people in there. So I sit outside. And I said, I'm going to wait till one of the homies call me. But if they don't call me back, I'm going back home. Y'all didn't call me back in time. By 12 o'clock, I was back at home. Because I'm like, it's over with, isn't it?
You had been out for a while.
I know. But by 12 o'clock, I was back at the house.
Oh my goodness.
I couldn't take it. If I would have had a nap, I probably could have powered through. But you need a nap in between parties. You are above the age of 33.
I also think that when I see the same people so many times in a day, like I saw people on Friday night, and most of those people I saw again Friday during the tailgate, and a little bit extra because it was more people at the tailgate.
It's facts.
And then if I'm going to a day party, I'm going to see all those people that were at the tailgate. So it's like,
I'm seeing out.
I'm already pregnant. So that was like my number one thing. It just wasn't happening. Right. I was on, and I told Cameron that he could have some dad off duty.
Talk about it.
Time with his buddies. Yeah. And it was his homecoming. So it made more sense. If he wanted to party, he could. So
my boy turned up. He was there.
Yeah. I told him to go party with you, and I'll see him later. And then I kind of regretted that. But went to dinner, went to break tops. And by the time I got home, he was home, and
all was well. And then we
did the flex and went to reposted.
Hey, shout out to Winter. Winter was viral.
I gotta tell y'all, the flex is her shit.
Winter was viral.
I should have posted that on the actual.
Yeah, you should have.
Maybe I will. I don't know.
Run that back.
Some stuff is just story worthy.
Some stuff is just story worthy. It ain't got to be deep, I guess. And she said the words. I'm like, hey, Winter is starting up right now.
It's so funny to hear her say, you're so sexy. Because like, girl, what do you know about some sexy?
My girl hitting it. Hey, Winter was hitting it.
She's so funny.
But yeah, man, homecoming was a blast. So after that, Sunday night, I had one more thing to say about going out because you're too old. Now, if you are 33 and above and you're single, go out.
Party rock is in the house.
Keep going. You ain't got no reason to be in the house if you're 33 and you're single.
But again, if you are a guy, you're looking for your next queen. And you see me at all five parties that you're going to. You can be like, damn, this bitch old do be out.
Yeah. What if I stalled out and then ball out at those other parties, though? What if I saw you and my confidence on my outfit
but
wasn't quite
perfect? I think then that's when you find me on social media. Because at some point, you will have somebody would have known somebody that you probably knew somebody I was with. If we're in a homecoming style situation.
Yeah.
I won't say nine. I do a lot of nine times out of ten. I don't know why I started.
You do.
It's maybe it's a five times out of ten situation.
Six times.
You might know somebody I'm with. And if you do, you'd be like, hey, so who your homegirl?
Yeah. But what if you from out of town? One night only, I'm from out of town.
I mean, then you should have talked to me at one of the three parties that I was at.
But my nerves wasn't good.
But you still don't want, I don't feel like anybody wants somebody, and vice versa for a girl. If I'm at five parties and I see you at all the parties, like.
One of us got to set our black ass down.
Right. Everybody don't want somebody
to both spending
outside.
Money on you.
Right. Especially at this big age.
Hey, them drinks though. God bless. I don't drink. I don't see how y'all do it. I bought a few people drinks, probably like six.
Oh.
Looked at my bill, like $300.
I bet it was. Especially on that top notch.
That's what I'm talking about. And then look, so I put my card on file. Fellas, a mistake. If your lady is going out with her friends, do not tell her that your card is on file and you started a tab. Next thing I know, people bringing this, hey, Mr. Newsom, this is for you. Plate of salmon. Y'all don't even eat seafood. Mr. Newsom, this is for you. They don't even drink alcohol. 2 minutes later, Mr. Newsom, got some spinach and crab dip for you. Right there, y'all having Thanksgiving over there.
Who knew they had the dip over there?
They had it early. You should have came.
You know, we had
it. Yeah, I know. I feel
you. I'm pregnant, baby. Yeah. Had to drop off to him.
Indy cut her finger open. So let's talk about time management real fast. Ladies and gentlemen, you're always running late. And when you run late, you start to rush things like cutting open jewelry. You cut open, I don't know what she was cutting open, but
I was cutting some rings off of the thing it was attached to. And they have the zip tie.
Gotcha.
And they zip tie it so tight to the thing. So you have to kind of like slide the scissors under there.
You're doing it wrong already. You slide away from you.
I'm not a ring person anyway, so I don't really have these issues with jewelry. However,
Yeah.
She was moving probably a little bit too fast.
Andy was moving too fast and cut her finger open, needed to go to the urgent care. When she called me at first, she said, I'm going to the emergency room and my stomach started hurting. So all I could think about was that $500 copay. I said, oh Lord, are you okay? She's like, yeah, I just cut my finger. I want to say, man, you better put some dirt on this shit and get your ass to this party.
Oh, my goodness. She called me live from the urgent care. I was in the middle of the mall. I was like, oh. Because I think I texted her. I was like, what time you get to the party? And she FaceTimed me. And I was like, oh, okay. And she's like, I'm in urgent care. And I was like, bitch, what? I was like, wow, makeup, hair, dress.
She was in there. Put your cut on live. I give you $1,000. Called her live from the urgent care. Cut, finger, gashed. But she cut herself trying to open it, so slow down. I just want to get to know you. Everything is going to be fine when you're getting ready, okay? Shout out to Bobby.
She was trying to get out there. She was trying to get to dinner.
I understand, but she missed the dinner. I'm glad because they had plenty of food on the rooftop.
Oh, scrap. Well, they had to have plenty of the food on the rooftop because they didn't have dinner.
They didn't. It's facts.
Anyway, what was your next question about homecoming? Let's put that on.
I got a good question now.
What's up with the button?
I don't know, man. Hold on. I got a good question. I think I missed the press. I wrote this question down and I forgot. Homecoming recap.
Brother.
This is a question that we received from a listener. How do you handle seeing your partner's old hoes during an outing after marriage? So how do you handle that when you see somebody that your partner used to be involved with after, now that y'all are married? What do you do as the person who is seeing that person now?
And now, me and Cameron, we joke with each other.
Oh, okay. All right. Well,
so at the tailgate, he was like, your girl here. And I was like, who was my girl? And, you know, after looking around, eventually, like, I lay eyes and I'm like, and it's kind of like, nigga, that's your girl. You know what I'm saying? A young boy over there. And it's like,
Now, if he went to speak to that woman or that lady, could he?
The baby is saying no. The baby is saying no. Hold on. He is going nuts.
Cut
over
the
here.
Tape. We about to stop the bomb.
He is kicking me all in my ribs. I feel like when you go over to someone and talk to them, I think you are.
If you're going out of your way.
Yeah, going out your way. If y'all just happen to speak, you know what I'm saying? If that person comes and speaks to you, I don't think it's an issue speaking.
What about a hug?
We're not touching.
Okay. I really don't think you should speak or hug in front.
Like, I just would rather not. And especially when it's people that are so irrelevant now.
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of like, you know, what do you have to talk about? But if y'all passing, it's like a, hey, how you doing? Hey, how you doing? You know, type situation. We're not sitting here and catching up. But I will say.
Okay.
Because in the same breath, it also depends on the situation.
Okay.
So like me and Cameron have been out together and we've seen another couple. They're married. Someone from an ex of mine.
Okay.
And we were the four of us sitting there talking about you. You know what I'm saying? Just talking.
Like, it's like different phases, right?
Yes. Phases. And again, it's no bad blood over there. So it's like, I don't think it's bad blood anywhere. Because at this point, it's no fucking blood. The only blood is just between me and Karen and these children.
That's the real blood.
So now it's just like, you kind of laugh about it. I think it depends on who the person was from your past. Like if it's an ex, yeah, whatever. Oh, hey, how you doing? How's your mama? You know what I'm saying? You can do that. But if it's an ex and it's like, maybe it was a time that you were on and off.
That was a song. Ex about your mama. What song was that?
It's awkward. I don't know. It was something that caused like tension between the relationship. Then it's like, you know, not to go speak to that person.
See, okay.
I think it just depends.
Yeah, I feel
like everybody, y'all know what I'm talking about.
My next question on this whole situation is this then. You and the ex-girlfriend are, well, obviously it's your ex-girl. Y'all broke up. Bygones are bygones. Everybody doing good for themselves. But you are still cool with one of her friends. And you go up and you hug the friend. Bam.
Oh, okay.
And then you got your ex sitting right there. Bam. What do you do?
That actually happened.
What do you do? You got a business decision to make.
It depends on what that person does. Because in my situation, the friend was like, Sydney! And the other person just walked away.
And sometimes you got to just walk away.
Yeah. Okay. So I feel like it's just one of those things.
You got to make a business decision.
If that person's not trying to speak to
you,
because I'm not going on my way to speak to nobody. Yeah. If you speak to me, I say, hey, I ain't gonna be like,
I don't never want no smoke with nobody. I'm gonna speak to everybody.
But I will say, the last conversation I had with one of the people that I saw, it wasn't a good conversation. So it's
for
like,
real?
Yeah,
in public?
No, not in public. Said, like the last personal conversation we had, it was like, you're miserable.
Nice. That's
like, damn it. So it's like, you know, you saw how miserable I was at the
If our last conversation is like that, and we see each other, we are enemies. That we are sworn.
We're not enemies.
We are sworn enemies.
We just don't have nothing to talk about.
If anybody calls me miserable outside of the people I know, like, no, bro, I'm not speaking to you.
But it's like, I wasn't miserable then, and I'm really not miserable now.
Exactly. That's why I'm definitely going to speak
to you. And I bet you felt miserable seeing me and my baby daddy.
And
all my friends.
He was.
All right, next.
I ain't done with the docket. Hold on.
Ain't done with the topic.
I'm still here. So look, I thought about that now, like, because I hugged one person, but I didn't hug the other person because I don't want no problem. Because I don't know who she may be dealing with right now, and I don't know the perception of the hug. What I think is only a hug. The woman, my wife, may think it's something bigger than that. So I just think you got to be...
You got to know your partner.
Cognizant, right?
And again, if the situation between them could have been awkward at some point, it's like, that's just somebody we don't talk to.
Yeah, it is what it is. But I wish him well. I don't never want to see him doing bad or anything. So, but you know what? I like what you said. I would feel more inclined to speak to that person if they were with somebody else. If they had a boyfriend or husband or something and I saw them, I would probably speak to them.
Not more inclined. I think I think speaking would be more fluid.
Easy.
Yeah. It wouldn't be as awkward. It's not as awkward when the other person moved on as well.
More fluid. Give it up for fluid one time. Not gender fluid. Speak fluid. I like that. I like it. Give it up. Hey, it was fire. It was fire. All right. Now, we saw something. I'm going to hit the button real fast before we get into this.
During the week, we got deep.
I got to talk about NBA too. I got to stop.
Let's talk on the podcast.
I got an announcement to make, man. And it reminds me of my wife. And your wife may not be like this, but mine sure the hell is. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to make a PSA, a public service announcement. Do not try out new recipes that you haven't thoroughly vetted when you know your partner may be having a long day at work and maybe a little bit hungry and you want to try a new recipe. It's not the best idea. Opt out. Stick to the macaroni and chicken that you're used to. Don't go chasing pot roast. India made a goddamn pot roast last week. That made my knees weak, made my taste buds itch, made me want to spit, but I didn't do it.
Mary.
I'm driving. Now, it's not her fault. I don't think it was her fault. I saw her prepping, and her prep game looked strong. Now, y'all know India, when she cooks, she leaves every damn dish she has out on the counter.
Why are you just kicking it back in?
No, she did a good job because she tried. I give it up for her for trying. So boom, I get home, get ready to enjoy some pot roast because I do like a pot roast, little carrot, potato, meat, little onion, little gravy. I was excited, right? She calls me, hey, you might want to stop and get the kids something to eat. I said, why? She says, because I don't think they're going to like this pot roast. I said, why? She said, because it's sweet. And I said, you know, I like sweet meat. Hey, yo, but.
No diddy.
No diddy. She was like, yeah, I think it's a little sweet. And I'm like, all right, well, I'm going to stop and make them some when I get home and stop and get them some. But I asked, what about me? Oh, I think you would like it. So I said, cool. I didn't get myself anything to eat. Got home, opened up the pot roast, put it in the bowl. I got a big ass bowl, too. I ain't getting no. I got a helping. Got a hungry man bowl. Put that shit in that bowl. Taste it. I said, nah, it's probably the first bite. It was a carrot. I said, maybe the carrot. That carrot was a little stale. Let me dig in.
Not a stale carrot.
Got a piece of the meat. Put it in my mouth. And I said, I chew. I said, nah, this ain't it. I called India and said, hey, I think something went bad in your pot roast. She said, what do you mean? I think something went bad. Like you cooked something that had an expiration date on it that had passed. That's what it tastes like. It tastes on a lot of levels like a warhead. You ever had a warhead before?
I have.
So it off sour, end up sweet. She was right. It was sweet and sour at the same time. I said, how did you make warhead candy out of pot roast? I was mind blown, right? And I, you know, she was very like apologetic about it. She was like, I know it tastes weird. I'm like, nah, it's just it's nasty. That's how it tastes. But it's not her fault. Give it up for India for cooking one time. It's not her fault. It was something wrong with that meat. She got the recipe from you, didn't she? You knew what she was cooking.
No, I didn't. She told me she was cooking it. Now you're trying to bring me in and know she did not cook
it. Come with me. Come on, get it. Jump in the car.
She didn't get the recipe for me. I didn't know she was, but she told me she was making a pot roast. We talked that day. And I said, she's like, I cooked a pot roast all day. And I was like, oh, so when I came over to record the pot.
You still saw the pot roast sitting
out? Yes, and I said, oh, and I sniffed. It smelled great.
It did smell good.
So I was like, oh, how was the pot roast? And that's when you proceeded to tell me.
The pot roast had all the makings of a phenomenal meal until you put it in your mouth.
How? Oh my
God. And then all hell rained down.
Well, I will say that some recipes, depending on what you put in it, like some pot roast recipes, like they want you to have like red wine in it. Mm. I don't really like red wine in some of my dishes because I could still taste the red wine. And I don't know if that just means it hasn't reduced enough.
Okay.
These are cooking terms. But I prefer...
Sydney Ramsey over here.
I prefer a roast without it. Because okay. I fucked up on a roast before too. It's easy to mess up on a meal. Your first time trying it. So yeah. I will say you still have to test it out in order to see if it's going to be a hit or not.
But you also have to do well when you cook. Taste.
Yeah, you have to taste and you have to take your time.
She does neither.
And normally with a crock pot condition, you just throw all the shit in the crock pot and let it cook for 8 hours and then boom, shakalaka. It's supposed to be.
Boom, shakalaka. Let me tell you why I love my wife too. This is crazy shit ever. My girl would go out and buy the most expensive of cuts of meats too, just to fuck them up.
Oh like, my goodness.
She went to Whole Foods. She had the goddamn paper around the meat from the butcher.
Yeah.
Look nice. I said, oh, you're cutting meat. Cutting it up. I saw the prep. In my mind, I'm thinking, why you ain't go to Walmart and buy like the ground chuck already?
First of all,
they got the cuts already. The stew meat.
Yeah. But
why
that's
you
not
go to Walmart
because
get the stew
that's
meat?
For stew. That doesn't necessarily mean
ain't
it goes.
Pot roast and stew the same thing?
No. That's why they're not the same.
Okay. Okay.
But you are supposed to use like a, I want to say it's still a chuck, but it depends on like what part of the meat. Some people do like a shoulder or a butt. It just depends on what I forget. Honestly, the pregnancy. I don't even know what part I use, but it's a whole piece.
Sourest part of the cow? They got sour part.
I don't think the meat was sour. I think it was an ingredient.
You got to put that sour sop in there. I said, hold up.
I don't think sour sop is even sour.
For real?
I don't know.
Why they call it sour sop if it ain't sour then?
I don't know.
She is sour. She put it in there and I'm like,
I don't think it was the meat though.
Yikes.
I think it was probably an ingredient.
Well, anyway.
I have to ask her what
I love my wife and I appreciate her for trying to cook. But
the next time she tries it, it'll be a hit.
She made some chicken wings last night. She only made like 12 of them or 15 of them, but they were fire.
How good.
I couldn't even eat like I wanted to eat because I had to save. I got 4 kids. Shiloh eating like a man. Blake eating like a granddaddy. You know what I'm saying? I got to save them some food. I'm like, man, it's fucked up. But anyway, I digress. Let's talk about 666. It's a nasty thing, man. I didn't even like writing. So I put They'll scratch it out real fast.
They're screaming.
And they have this thing on TikTok called the 666 equation.
That's my first time hearing about this.
Really? I saw it when I was looking for stuff to talk about. I ain't gonna lie. It said women now have this thing where you need to be 6 feet or more, have six-pack of abs, and have a six-figure salary for you to be with them. How you feel about that?
I feel like that's where a lot of people are single right now.
Talk about
it. I hear dating. I hear the dating pool sucks.
Now, y'all waiting for you. I was waiting for you to get done.
I hear the dating pool sucks right now anyway. I would hate to be having to, you know, put myself out there and be dating in 2024 because I heard it's just a shit show. I feel like social media is leading so much of what we think is important and it's not.
None of
this
stuff is important.
If you're not, you know, doing this, if you're not making 6 feet, like obviously, like at some point, the person that you're dating, you of course you want them to be well off. You want them to have like a good job. It doesn't you don't have to be the CEO of the company. It'd be great if you are.
Facts.
But it's like you have a good job. You have insurance. That means that you have health benefits and that you are going to the doctor for all your appointments, your physicals, your teeth cleanings, your ear checks, and eye checks. Yes, we love people with good hygiene. So that's why I'm more worried about your job than anything else. The salary is also the benefit.
Yeah, it's facts.
The 6 feet tall. I'm short, so everybody's 6 feet to me besides this guy.
Besides that old work, give it up.
Oh my God. Anyway, Cameron's not 6 foot. He's almost 6 foot.
Cam is six. I guarantee
you. No, he's
6 feet.
Like 5'10. He's like average height.
Okay.
But standing next to me, Cameron looks like he's 6'2.
Standing next to me, like he's 6'2 too. Shit.
So, again, I like a taller guy. I mean, I didn't want to marry someone the same height as me, but I'm short naturally. So it's like two short people, we're gonna have a short kid.
Yeah. I want to give my kid a chance. I said that one time, by the way. I told you this story. We'll talk about it. Keep going.
And then the 6 figure salary, in this economy. You kind of got to be the CEO to be making
You better be 5 or 5 and some change. 5 and some change.
I think that, you know, that's some of these, because it's kind of like, do you have these things?
That's my question. Well, ladies, let me tell y'all. Do you got what you asking for?
Yeah, I mean, not the 6 foot part, because I mean.
Yeah, I don't want no lady.
I'm far from that, but it's like.
I don't want no tall 6 foot.
What are we, will we be receptive to. What a guy's... Did you see what the guy's standards are?
Nah, I
didn't. Y'all want big titties, big booty.
There you go. What?
OnlyFans looking.
There you go. And so, no, that's the kicker. Guys can't say that. Girls can go online and say stuff like this and not get their back kicked in. If I were to go online and say I want teeth, titties, and toes. You want 666? I want teeth, titties, and toes. You were like, oh, nah, I ain't got no big titties.
But I do feel like, again, this is where it's all like, to me, all of this stuff is just so materialistic.
It is. I just want somebody to love me for me.
Yeah. You know I just want somebody.
Hey.
I mean, for real. So,
yeah, I did it. It's like, I mean, obviously, you want somebody attractive, right? Or on your attraction level. Because if you can outkick your coverage, great. But if you can't outkick, you know what I mean? Outkicking your coverage. Outkicking your coverage. People used to tell me that all the time. And I was like, that means I'm desirable then, ain't it? They would see India and be like, man, you outkicked your coverage. Just like a white term, a white.
It means you look better than India?
No, she looks better than me.
Oh,
so when you outkick your coverage, nobody's there on the field of football term. But anyway.
Okay.
I say all that to say.
Touchdown.
White men love saying that to you when they see you. Like in corporate settings. Man, embarrassing did good for yourself. You outkicked your coverage, didn't you, bud? yeah, whatever. She fine. Yeah. So yeah, I mean, you want somebody attractive.
Yeah.
Everybody can say that.
Yeah.
Other stuff, you know, is feelers. Like I used to be vain, right? So I wanted somebody
shallow half
over here. Want somebody with some. They kept their hair done. I really wanted somebody that kept their hair done and kept themselves looking good. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But that's my personal preference. But if she ain't come with that. It wasn't a deal breaker. Like, this 666 is crazy to me. Like six figures, six pack. How many people realistically got six pack of abs? That's just like me going to the gym or not going to the gym rather and saying, man, I want a girl with just like a booty that sit up like a shit. Who got a nice booty? I don't know nobody with a nice booty.
Oh my God. Joy.
Like me going and saying, man, I want a booty, a girl with a booty like Joy Chavez. Ain't too many booties, real booties like that. You know what I'm saying? If you go to the gym.
But I feel like instead of saying he got to have a six pack, maybe just say like, I want him healthy.
There you go. It's a way.
Yeah.
Like, that's I mean, I correct way
a,
to say
a bigger guy or a guy that's letting himself go. I want somebody that cares about his health.
Yeah.
At least me, you know, going to the gym and doing something.
Now, what if you get the person that has the six-pack ab, it is 6 feet tall, and it does have a six-figure job. And then 2 months later, they get laid off. And then a month after that, they get a four-pack because they sit up and depressed, eating out of depression.
Mm-hmm.
Now they got a two-pack because they keep going. Are you going to leave?
You looking at me? Should I?
That's just what I'm saying.
I feel like, again, when you get with somebody, and then especially when you marry somebody, it's supposed to be through sickness and health.
It's supposed to be
what you look like now and then what you might look like later on. Now, obviously, you're supposed to be there to help your partner not fall off the bandwagon.
So right,
Cameron
right.
saw me getting big as a house, bigger than I am now.
Yeah,
and I would hope that he'd be like, you know, hey, babe, let's start going for walks. That's when you're supposed to try to, you know, kick your partner back into gear and help them get to, you know, get back to their hopefully desirable status for themselves. And then, of course, seeing that desire makes you more desirable towards that person, right?
And specs, unless y'all getting big together.
Yeah, I mean, or we could be doing big back activities. But we shouldn't be. We should be trying to live a healthy lifestyle so we can be here for our kids have kids and their kids have kids and...
It's facts.
Yeah.
You touched on something we need to talk about real fast before we get WWID. And that's when you said I don't know how you said this, but you made me think about it. But men, Tyrese Maxey and Bryce Young. Bryce Young is the ex-Panther starting quarterback.
Oh, yeah.
Tyrese Maxey. Tyrese Maxey is the max point guard for the Philadelphia 76ers. Now, it's been all over the internet that Bryce Young's girlfriend broke up with him just to start talking to Tyrese Maxey not long after that.
Nasty word.
Why do celebrities and athletes like to get with the same work? Speaking of work.
I don't know. I feel like it's weird. It makes me feel like their dating pool is even smaller.
And that's what I gave them some credit. I said, we don't know how big their dating pool is, but we do know how big Instagram is.
And we do know how big the world is. Like if you're a football player or a celebrity, you're traveling the world. You can literally have a girlfriend in every different city. Why would I want somebody that... My homeboy that played for the whoever.
That's what I'm saying, bro. Like, come on,
I don't know. Then I started reading the comments and it said, like, this is her fourth athlete.
Yeah, she's like,
which is crazy because, like, girl, you might need to tell these girls where they can find some athletes.
666. She may start the equation and she got it on lock if she started it because,
yeah, I don't know. I think it's a little weird, especially when they have children with all these different people. It's like, dang.
It's strange. About that. In your in your small town, right? Or you're in Nashville.
Mm-hmm. Like our small town.
What if people just start dating like the same work? Like,
well, I mean,
popular people who date the same work.
I've known a few people date the same people. Mm-hmm. I've had a few people I know date my exes. One girl told me I like him. I said, "Girl, go do you." I
Stop
mean, that's
lying.
Why we were together. Yeah.
She asked you for permission.
Low key, I think it wasn't permission. Nice. It was like she just wanted to let me know that she liked him.
Okay. It's respectable.
We weren't friends. Like this wasn't somebody I considered a friend, but it's like I guess she felt like you know.
Get my old work. This is cool.
But that's weird.
It is weird.
Whatever, girl, do you. I was like,
that's weird.
Nah, I'm on to the next as well. So enjoy that.
I don't got mine over here.
Yeah, I think it's weird when it's in the same like friend group. Like if he was friends with that guy and then started dating this girl, that's really weird.
Yeah, that is strange. But I do think the dating pool there is small. Somebody said in the comments too, like, hey, you can go literally on OnlyFans and find the same girl. I'm like, damn, why y'all doing that girl like that? So
again, I feel like it's just a social media effect. Like you want what you think that everybody wants.
Have you seen those AI accounts? those AI girl accounts, like they make girls and they look like real women, but it's AI.
It's hard to tell what's real and what's fake these
days.
That's
what I'm saying. They look like real.
So you women. And they're talking to a robot?
Yes, people do. They be liking the picture and everything. Then if you go to the comments, they say AI. I'm like, y'all next.
AI ain't it real. AI ain't it fake.
AI, you don't know. AI is too late.
Hey,
it's what it is.
Young drunk.
Is liking it right now. So be careful. Don't be fooled. You DMing some AI work out here. It's nasty. Listen. Work. It's nasty work. Anyway, let's go and get to WWSD. Big C, are you ready? Let's hit the button.
Let her upgrade you.
I'm on fire today.
What would India do?
My buttons work.
Yeah, sometimes.
My buttons work. WWSD. Talk about it.
Okay. It says, my wife and I are both 40, married for 10 years, and we have a pretty normal relationship with multiple kids. I don't suspect her of cheating, but here's the thing. Before every one of her business trips, which happens 4 to 5 times a year, she always shaves her private area. I've mentioned that it makes... It feels strange to me, especially since she doesn't go swimming on these trips and we already have a pool at home.
Woof.
I told her that if the roles were reversed and I started grooming down there before my trips, she'd probably lose it, and she's the more jealous type in our relationship. She just giggles whenever I bring it up and doesn't really address my concerns. She works for the federal government, so these are professional trips.
Good job.
Should I be worried someone else is seeing her shaved cat?
Meow. He said he want to see that shave monkey.
First of all, why are we still shaving in 2024? Ladies, let me give you a Sydney relationship.
Put them on game.
If you are 21 and up, damn, I spit.
It's all good.
If you are 21 and up, you need to be finding your nearest European wax center. If you're in Atlanta, the Sweet Peach, somewhere.
Give it up.
That, right. I miss that place dearly. Get you a wax. Waxing, it lasts longer. Your skin looks better. And it's just overall better for your womanly health.
Mm.
You know? Yeah, just, yes, do that. So that's number one.
Okay.
I think that grooming before a trip does look suspicious. And if you don't do it on a regular.
Bingo.
For me, that is a part of my maintenance. I told y'all.
You did.
I'm my sexiest when I am shaved.
You did.
Wax, because I still shave my legs, my underarms.
Yeah.
Wax is my brows, my...
Yo.
And my... Lick my... All of that, I prefer for it to be waxed. So, I say all that to say, if I was only getting waxed when it was time for me to go somewhere... Cameron will probably look at me like But I will say, it's been times where I've teased Cameron because he'll be grooming. I'm like, where the fuck you think you go?
Hey, I do the same thing.
I know, what?
I ain't
gonna
lie. He's
the
same
way.
It is the same
way. Wait till you get back to do that. But I do it jokingly. I'm not thinking that, oh, Cameron's shaving his balls because he's about to go stick them in somebody else's mouth. Cameron's not trying to die.
The tea bag.
So... I feel like maybe you should talk to her about like her normal upkeep of herself and be like, you know, it makes me feel a way that you only do this when you're about to go out of town. Now she could just be like, okay, if we did do an outing where it gets adventurous, because I know sometimes on corporate trips, they like to take y'all ATV rider or zip line or some shit like that. So I get that part. Yeah. But if that's not part of the trip, it does look suspicious.
Yeah.
So I can say on the reverse side, I feel him, because if he was just shaving his balls, like, oh yeah, I'm about to go to South Dakota to this conference, and you sitting there like, but you ain't shaving your balls in 6 weeks with me, and we had a pool outside. What's the difference? So I mean, I feel him. Maybe she just need to do that on a regular. Add that to her regular routine. But I know that some women like, okay, y'all don't care if we still having sex
on a regular
routine, and you don't care about my woof, my braids, or my bald, you know, then maybe I don't feel so inclined. But it does look away when you're going somewhere for a business trip.
Look away. having South Dakota balls is nasty, by the way.
I don't even know why I said that.
If you got fresh balls in South Dakota... You might be going to see Dakota. Do you see what I'm saying?
But I don't
think it's suspicious. I do think it's strange though, because I'm like, maybe she likes to just have a full cleanse before she goes out of town.
I think that her laughing it off makes it seem like, oh, you so crazy. But it's like, nah.
Are you trying to hide some with the laugh?
It looks weird.
Yeah.
It looks weird. Now, again, if Cameron only shaved his balls when he was going to Nissan events, then I would feel some type of way. But if he shaves his balls normal, then it's like, okay, I feel you. You going somewhere hot? You want to make sure you're not hot if y'all are doing some stuff, driving cars outside? Then it makes sense. But you have to still respect your partner and their feelings.
Respects. Respects.
That makes them feel some type of way, which it sounds like it does.
Now, watch this, though. What if she only keeps the wolf because he likes it, and this not her regular style? Like, her normal style is to have a clean shaved cat.
I don't think I've ever heard a man say, I prefer you to have hair over not having hair.
You won't hear it over here.
And again, I've been bald for about 20 plus years at this
nigga
point.
Michael Jordan.
I am not going back, and I refuse to be shaven. So I think that when you are a shaver, though, you know hair grows back. You shave your face and stuff like this. You know your hair, you're going to have a 5 o'clock shadow by tomorrow.
Got it.
So I don't, you know, again, I can't really put her math to math. Maybe she just doesn't. Maybe she just cleans up.
But now she doing designs on that thing.
Oh my God, landing strips and stuff. Now she...
She for sure.
If she's cleaning it up, it's one, and then she shaves it completely off. I don't know. Again, there's levels to... Your body hair.
Yeah, it is. It
you
is.
You have a little off the top. You have a bush. You can have a bald.
I give myself
know.
A bald fade. I ain't gonna lie. I straight up got a bald fade.
Me too.
I straight up got
but
a bald fade.
I feel like she should respect his feelings.
That's crazy. Yeah, like.
And not laugh them off.
Don't laugh my man's feeling off. And my man, for you, you need to just tell, hey, I feel disrespected. Like, I feel like you doing that to show somebody that cat. And if she ain't trying to show somebody that cat, she's not doing a good job dispelling the rumor.
Or maybe he needs to pop up on a trip. Ooh, yikes.
Oh. Yeah, I'm here to see Miss Johnson. What room? Who are you? I'm her husband. Oh, right this way, Mr. Johnson. Miss Johnson, with her legs spread like 6:45. Wide open.
Just 10 and 2.
10 and 2. Here they are. Somebody in there. No.
Oh, my God. That's real nasty work.
Man, you walk in seeing somebody getting a pound town on your woman. Listen, on a trip.
I'm already coming there with it. So I guess I'm going to jail and everybody about to die.
I got it on me. But work trip dynamics, though, are big. I wrote that down because you have to have work trip etiquette, too. Like, if you do go on a trip with your woman, like you talked about it before, there are certain things you should and shouldn't wear when you go on work trips. Like, if we go on a work trip, for her example, and if we are out and I got my just hair sprouting all out my bikini, it's going to look crazy. Then if I bring you as my husband and you got like y'all hair growing all over your back, your chest, your neck, and coming out the top of your swimsuit, it looks wild. So I understand it from their point of view. You know what I mean? But like just going.
He said there wasn't no pool when she was going.
He did say it wasn't no pool. I can't even cap for you. Like, I'm trying to.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They just got to have to get that shit together.
Good luck. Good luck. That's all we got for you. Wish you would. Let me hit the button. I got something to say. Let's do it.
Now, unqualified advice from B Love and B Love's relationship.
I got the keys. This week, my relationship mainly goes out to the ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, but mainly ladies. I want y'all to give men the same courtesy that we give you all when you go out with your friends. While we are out with our friends, normally 9 times out of 10, stealing your phrase, you guys are going to text us, check in on us, see what we're doing. Did we make it? Are we safe? What did we eat? What are y'all doing next? Who's there? What time you think you're coming home?
What kind of y'all they got on?
We don't need all of these questions. Now, when y'all are out, we probably normally ask one thing. Let me know when you make it. Let me know when you're leaving on your way home. That's all we want to know. All that stuff in between, we could really care less. As long as you are out having fun and you make it home safe, we're good to go. Y'all need to know too much. You start texting me while I'm out with the homies. I'm chilling, catching the vibe. I see 35 text messages coming.
I'm not doing all of that.
You got
no.
See, it's good.
But, you know what? I'm going to to scroll and see how many times I text Cameron while he was at Get Lit.
You may be the Monday. You may be the not the majority, but that other word. Oh, I can't think of it right now. I got pregnancy brain sitting beside you. The minority. You are in the minority because normally women do send a text. Hey, what are you doing? What time thing? You all right? You say, who all there? What you got going
on? And I was slow texting back too. He would text me. So let's see. He told me he was headed to the party. I said, enjoy. And that we might go get something to eat.
Okay.
He said, keep him posted and let him know if there's anything he can do to help.
That's fire. Give it up for that.
My response was, LOL, not sure what you can do from the party.
You know what he could have did? Sent you a cash app. There you go.
Anyway, right. Let's see. He told me when he made it. I told him.
That's all you need to know.
Winter had her first shower. She got the shower with me.
Big Winter getting bathed, showered.
And he asked me if she enjoyed it. I said she did. And then I asked him how the party was. He asked me where we're going to eat. And we told each other to enjoy. And the next time I text him is that I was at the restaurant. No, he told me either closing the tab out. I said, I'm still at the restaurant. Then I told him I was headed home. He said he's going to leave soon.
It's a good woman.
We saw each other at home. We kept it brief. It wasn't a lot going on.
Some of y'all don't know how to be. Y'all don't know what brevity is. Brevity could come smack you in the face and you wouldn't know what it was because your ass is too busy concerned about the fun. How am I here having?
I feel like we get a little jealous of sometimes when y'all be outside having fun.
That's what I'm saying. Women, men.
And I won't even say jealous. It's just because we know how the niggas are when we go out. We go out, we having a good time. Da, 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 da.
Yeah.
There's some niggas that's asking us to come to the section. If y'all get a section, y'all gonna have bitches in the section. But we know this. And then if you Mr. Friendly and can talk to a wall like you,
I'm turned up.
You know what I'm saying? We might have a few more questions for you. You might need to keep you a little bit more distracted on the phone than, you know, whatever.
Women don't want to see us have too much fun, man.
We don't.
Disguise your fun.
I'm going to be honest for us. We don't want to see y'all having too much fun.
Just, I got you. You got to disguise your fun.
We don't want to see y'all having too much fun, especially without us.
That's facts.
But if we are in the same party, I will say, at your party, for example, me and Cameron weren't together the whole time.
Now, y'all weren't.
He was flowing the room, kiki, kaka, and I was, you know, doing my thing.
Work the room.
Yeah,
work
I feel like just because you go to a party together doesn't mean you have to stay together.
That's a good tip, too. If you go to the party with your woman, don't be all up under her butt.
Unless we're in a section. Unless we have a section and we're just in the section. That's one thing.
I'm on everybody but in the section. I'm monitoring these drinks.
But I feel like, you know, if we're in a space where you know people that I may not know and I may know people you may not know, we can
do your thing.
Fly around the room and then come back together, dance. Do the same thing. Yeah.
That's it. That is.
Man. I'm going home with your ass regardless.
Disguise the fun. That's the tip. The fun.
Don't disguise it. Disguise we still want y'all to have a good time, but we are going to naturally always be more worried than you guys are.
Yeah, because I don't give
even
a
if
shit.
You were just going to the mall.
That's facts. Now, if I go to the strip club, then you got some questions to ask me.
I mean, not even necessarily. You have to know your man. Because Cameron's not a strip club guy. I'm more of a strip club girl than he is a strip club guy.
Talk about it. I used to be a strip club king back in the day and going there with $100, leave out with two. Throw it all in
$2. I was about to say, you leaving that with $200?
Nah,
$2.
If I go to the strip club with $100 and I leave out with two, that means I would land some of that pipe of light down. You feel me? Right in the VIP.
Yeah.
You don't know nobody done that before?
Realistically. How about I say, you ain't never done it? No, I don't think I've ever fucked a stripper in the VIP.
I would like to think not. You go to a male strip club?
I've been to a male strip club.
You had a bunch of glisses in your face?
It's No, I was with a bachelorette party.
It's wild.
And most
wild
of those guys are gay. Actually, we took my grandma one time. Me and my mom, and it was a gay strip club. Oh my God. Most men are gay in the strip club.
They got the banana hammock on,
and they don't get butt naked. That's another thing about men's strip clubs. They're not in there like ass titties and ass on and coochie like a regular strip club. They normally always have a thong on or something at the least.
Swinging.
And I don't want to see no man ass cheeks shaking in my face. And I really don't want to see no soft lip biscuit shaking in my face. So it's like
they're swinging Richard on you.
I prefer to go to a regular strip club, a woman's strip club.
Regular? You can say that. It's okay. I know it's 2024.
With chicken wings and titties.
That chicken wing, titties, teeth, and toes is all we want. That's what I want. Six equations.
Smell like juicy fruit.
Titties, teeth, toes and chicken wings, CW.
And fake titties and BBLs.
I'm okay with that. As long as it moved the right way, I'm cool with BBLs.
And just keep it on my man lap.
Well, that's what we're going to the strip club for. Tell the people where they can find you.
_ Syd the kid.
You can find me at a strip club near you.
No, you will find him at a home with his children and his wife. Lying, boy,
because I'm talking, I got all the kids with me. Bring them to me. I'm taking them all. Be Love 1911 and She and Our Podcast. We'd love to hear from you. Let us know. But in the meantime, in between time, it's been real. It's been fun. Syd, I'm out.